So I have to share, no?
That's good.
Always share, always share, share, share. Share screen, okay.
You got it?
Yeah. I got it. So everybody is able to see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay, let us start with the prayer, okay?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So first is Namaste. What does Namaste mean?
That the consciousness in you is the same in the consciousness in me, and we are joining it. I mean, we're coming together.
Okay, the God in you is consciousness in your heart, and my heart are one and same. I respect to you. Okay. So you didn't introduce Shiva. You didn't introduce. Just say hi. So here is Shiva.
Hello.
Hi.
He's in 7th standard.
Hello. Hi, Vinny.
Okay, so let's start. Let us offer our respect to our first, our inner light. We have divine light in our heart. Antar Jyotihi.
Antar Jyotihi.
Bahir Jyotihi.
Bahir Jyotihi.
Satyak Jyotihi.
Satyak Jyotihi.
Paraspara. Jyotireva
Jyotihi.
Swayam Jyotihi. What it means is, I have a divine light, that the God's light in my heart. So that is lighting up my heart, my body, and I am able to see the world because of this divine light. And that divine light is called Atma Jyoti. Okay? So, recognizing that divine light, I call you all children as Atma Jyotis. Is it okay for you?
Yes.
So I am respecting the divine light in you. Okay. So for example, I'll call Atma Jyoti Vini. I'll call Atma Jyoti Ojal. Okay. So this is my gurus, my masters. I just offer their respect to my gurus. The top one is called Ajja. Okay. This is actually Gaurapada Acharya. This is Ramana Maharshi, Shankaracharya, Amritanamayi. All these are my gurus. So we'll have to offer our respects to gurus. Brahmanandam.
Brahmanandam.
Paramasukamadam. Kevalam.
Kevalam.
Anamurtim. Tadvatitam.
Tadvatitam.
Kusham. Adi Laksham,
Adi Laksham,
Ekam Nityam,
Paramatam,
Akshibhutam,
Akshibhutam,
Trikuna Rahitam, Guru Brahma,
Guru Vishnu,
Guru
Devo,
Guru Saksha,
Guru Sakshat, Para Brahma,
Gurave
Namaha,
Chaitanyam. Shashvatam Shantam.
Shashvatam
Shantam.
Shashvatam
Shantam.
Shashvatam
Shantam.
Shashvatam
Shantam. Shashvatam
Shantam.
Tatpadam
Darshitam Yena
Gurave
Namaha
Gnanamoolam
Guru Murti
Puja
Moolam
Mantra Moolam
Mantra Moolam
Vakyam
Moolam
Guru Krapa. Okay, now we offered our respect to Guru, right? What is the guru and what is the difference between a guru and a teacher? You have so many teachers, right? Science teacher, mathematics teacher, physics teacher, guru, and different teachers. Is there a difference between guru and teacher?
Yeah. Guru teaches us about spirituality, and a normal teacher teaches us subjects.
Very good. So, did you hear? All of you hear? Or what Namit said? Did you hear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Namit said, all the teachers teach about subject, whereas guru teaches about spirituality. Right? What is spirituality?
Spirituality is something that comes from inside you.
Ah, very good. So, spirituality means there is a God in our heart, okay? Deep inside.
Okay.
God is the one who gives our strength. God is the one which makes our heart beat. There is peace inside us. We have to recognize the peace and love inside us. So, that's called spiritual life, okay? So the purpose of the guru is teaching God and peace and love in us. Are you clear?
Yes.
Okay. So let us take up the today's topic. Okay. So last time, what did I tell? What did I teach? Anybody remembers? What was the last class? Anybody remembers? Okay, so
and the monks of I think Buddhist monks who could imagine, and they were their imagination was so pinpoint and particular.
Very good. So imagination, okay. Okay, I'll ask one by one so that everybody participates. Okay.
Yes.
So let's start with the Aditya here. Okay. Yeah. Aditya?
The imagination and
imagination
and how they knew like the stars and
how the
astrologers and they knew the stars.
Yeah, can you clarify?
That's all I remember.
Okay, what about you,
Atreya? Krishna Paramahamsa, how his imagination was so clear that he could imagine Durga Devi in front.
Very good.
He used to feed her, play with her.
So what is the message for you in that?
That I also need to make.
So we did an exercise, right?
Yeah, to imagine the park.
Yeah, I gave you some exercise to do at home. So did you do that?
The Ramakrishna Paramahamsa story.
No.
How to train our muscle.
How to train your brain muscle. You have been doing it. Okay, so you tell me what you did and what is the result?
Imagining something.
Like something is what? Is specific, no?
Like my school.
Okay.
Sometimes how things could have been different or like different realities.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm
here.
I don't know how I've improved with anything.
You don't know improvement. Okay. Yeah. What about you?
Then I've done some imagination.
Like what? Example?
Like I sometimes I wish I had a dog, so I imagine how life would be
if I had a dog. If you had a dog, okay. How life will be? Okay, what type of dog is that?
I don't know, like I like cocker spaniel.
Huh?
I like cocker spaniel.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, nice. So let us hear Namit.
Yeah.
Namit, what did you do?
I finished all the assignments of how to train my muscle and Ramakrishna.
Okay. So what did you do? What exercise did you do to train your mind muscle? Imagination.
To train my muscles, what I did is I was doing yoga, swimming, and all.
No, that's not muscle. I was speaking only imagination muscle, no? The brain muscle.
Yeah.
We spoke of muscle of the brain, right? So that is
around the eye, I spoke that.
No, not around the eye. The mind, the brain, imagination is the exercise, no? How to improve our imagination?
How to improve our mind?
Mind. For what?
I think so.
Okay. Mind, not bad. Not, it's okay. So we need
Guruji?
Yes.
I think it could be writing poems and doing something creative.
Oh, okay. You write poems?
Yeah, sometimes.
Oh, wonderful. What kind of poems?
Mostly something non-fictional. Fictional.
Anything what?
Fictional.
Fictional.
Okay. Very nice. So, Vineet?
Yeah, so I did two things. One was the to-do list, but I didn't do it every day. I did it for a few days, like weekends where I do more work, like where I'm at home and I can do more stuff.
Okay.
And the imagination part, so my mom said you can go and sit and meditate and imagine what you would like your business to do and how should it be and all that.
Right.
So I imagined it and I even went to the color of the uniform and all that stuff.
Wow. How much money you made?
Imagination is 2 million.
Okay. 10% for me.
Dollars.
10% for me.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So what about Shiva?
I did everything. For imagination, whenever I'm going to the school bus or at home and I'm bored, nothing to do, then I just close my eyes and then imagine about whatever the first thing that comes to my mind.
Like what?
Like, for example, that park one also.
Okay.
Think about the park, making it more accurate, and then my school,
Is it helping you?
Yeah.
How it's helping?
This thing. I'm also thinking about question paper. How question paper.
Okay, you're guessing. Okay, he's guessing exam college question papers. What about Jairam? Jairam? Are you there?
I think it's muted. His icon is muted.
Yeah, Jairam, you are muted. Can you unmute and speak?
No, he has to unmute.
Jairam?
It's muted. It's not moving.
It's jammed, right? I can't unmute also.
Okay,
we
can ask the other
person. Yeah,
he has. Power of the mind, okay? Mind power.
Hello?
Hello, yes?
Yes.
Okay. So I'll discuss one how to share this. No. So you're able to see the screen?
Yes.
We want to have a very powerful mind, right? Mind should be strong, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Why strong mind is required?
To succeed in life.
Succeed in life.
If you have a strong mind, you can push your body to the next thing.
What?
If you have a strong mind, you can push your body to do anything.
Wow, you can push your body to do anything. Okay. Very good. So I'll tell you a small story and then I'll tell something about a story, okay? Have you heard the story of Dhruva?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. What about anybody else here? Huh? What does Dhruva mean? Dhruva means pole star. Okay? It is not just pole star. Why pole star is important? Have you heard of pole star?
It stays in the same place.
Very good.
It's the sailors to navigate.
Well, pole star is in the same space, in the same place. Earlier days when they didn't have a computer compass, they used to see the pole star and navigate the ships. Is it understood?
Yeah.
So they see the sky.
Direction.
Correct? So, see, every star is moving now. One star doesn't move. Okay, so that they know where they are. In the sea, right? You understand?
Yeah.
So, I'll tell you how the name Dhruva star, the pole star came and why there is a name of Dhruva which is given to that. Why it was given and why it's important in our life, we'll tell you. Okay? So there was a young boy called Dhruva. All of you are able to hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
His father's name is Uttanapada.
Okay. Prabhuji, your voice is a little feeble. Can the volume be increased, please?
Okay, how do I do that?
Can you, if you can use the headset to the laptop, it will be clearer.
Okay, let me see. I have a headset.
Picture is clear, but voice is a little feeble.
What's coming from there?
No, you have to connect it to the laptop.
Yeah, is it better?
Yeah, yes, slightly better.
Yes.
Is it connected to the headset?
It's a microphone.
So if you just click the sound button on the bottom tray and select the micro.
Anybody can tell what is Suniti? Suniti means morals.
No.
Okay, somebody who has good in morals and somebody who has good in taste. So what is the difference? Good in moral and good in taste?
Yes.
Let us say you have a choice between good taste and good moral. What will you choose and why?
Taste as in, is it the food taste or what is the taste?
Taste means taste anything. No, I want this, I want that, is taste.
Okay.
I want a house, I want a big car, all those things. So it means good moral. I will do it good way, right way. That is moral. Right? You should have good taste, but always you should have with the, do it with a good moral, right?
Good moral.
Correct? Okay, so now what happened? One day, Dhruva wanted to sit on the father's lap. Okay? Suruchi didn't like it. She pushed him away. Right? Because he is a stepson. Right? So, Dhruva got hurt. He cried. Okay? My father is not loving me. So what did mother tell Suniti? So what should mother tell? Father loves you. But your father, mother is not, he is not being allowed to go near the father by the stepmother. Correct? So then what should he do? What he should do? What mother told him? Mother told him,
wait for the other brother to go
and... That's a tact, right? Okay. Don't worry. God will take care. Okay. God, pray to God and God will take care. Okay. Are you able to hear? Are you able to hear all of you?
Yes. Yes, we are. I'm able to hear.
Yeah, somebody's making too much of noise. Okay.
So I think everyone else, if you can mute, then disturbance will be less.
It's mute when you don't.
Iran, can you Iran, mute?
Mute when
you... Yeah, it's me.
Okay. When you speak, you enable it. Okay. So then Suniti told, God will take care, Vishnu will take care. Don't worry. Okay. Then Dhruva wanted to find out where is Vishnu. So where is Vishnu? Bhagavan Vishnu, where is he?
He's there everywhere.
Everywhere. But he wanted to find Vishnu. Okay. Dhruva just leaves the palace and starts going in the forest. He wants to find Vishnu. He wants to talk to Vishnu and tell his problem. My father is not taking care of me. Okay. So then Narada sees this child. And Narada feels pity on the child. He tells Dhruva how to pray Narayana. Okay? How to pray Narayana? How to pray Vishnu?
through bhakti.
So you have to imagine Vishnu in your heart, here, inside your heart, in the small form, okay? Are you clear? So Vishnu, he is a beautiful person with the four hands, Shankha, Chakra, Gada, Padma in his hand. He is sitting in your heart. And then what you have to chant? You have to chant, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. That means, Vasudeva means God is in my heart. Vasa, he stays in my heart. He stays in everybody's heart. So let us chant, okay? Visualize God in our heart. Imagine Vishnu is sitting in our heart. Okay? Beautiful, beautiful picture of Vishnu. Beautiful mediating light. Is a light coming from Vishnu. Sitting in your heart and sending peace throughout the body and mind. Let us mentally create a little chant. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Are you able to see clearly Bhagavan in your heart? How many of you? Yes. What about you? Day. What about you? How many people to see God clearly in your heart? Can you please raise your hand? Are you able to clearly visualize? Yes, Namit, yes. Atreya, yes. Shiva, yes. Okay. What about Jairam?
No.
Shiva, yeah. Okay. What about Jairam?
Yeah.
Okay. Describe what did you see?
I saw Lord Vishnu.
Okay. Ojal?
I saw a god and a lot of jewels, a lot of gold on him, but still a sense of simplicity around him.
Okay. Visualize God sitting there and peace coming into your heart. Your whole body is getting filled with peace and light and love. Is it okay? Pray to God. Show me, give me the peace, give me the love. Fill me with peace and love, okay? Visualize as clearly as possible the Lord sitting in your heart. Okay? Are we clear? Then we'll chant. Are we clear? So let your heart be filled with love and peace and happiness and strength, courage. God gives us the courage. Om Namo.
Om Namo.
Bhagavate. Vasudevaya. Bhagavate. Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo.
Om Namo.
Bhagavate.
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo.
Om Namo. Vasudevaya.
Om Namo.
Om Namo.
Bhagavate.
Bhagavate.
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo.
Om
Bhagavate. Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo.
Om Namo.
Bhagavate.
Vasudevaya. Vasudevaya.
Harihi Om.
Hari Om.
Now offer your prayer to God. Okay. I'll say and you please repeat. Bhagavan Vasudeva.
Bhagavan Vasudeva.
Mahavishnu.
Mahavishnu.
Give me.
Give me.
Peace,
strength,
peace,
happiness.
Bless me,
Just
with courage.
With courage.
Bless me.
Bless me.
So that. I am successful.
I am successful. In
my exams. In my school.
In my school.
In my life.
In my life.
Give me.
Wealth.
Wisdom. Protect me.
Protect me.
Do namaskara. Okay. So, is it clear to you how to do this prayer?
Yes.
Yeah, practice it, okay? The more you practice it, more God will appear to your heart. Very clearly. Right?
Protect me.
Okay, what happens when Dhruva did this? Okay? All the forest is full of animals, wild animals. Elephants came, the tigers came, and Dhruva is how old is he? 6-year-old boy. Okay? And what will happen if you sit in the forest and the elephant comes? Wild elephant. Right? The tiger comes, he is worried. Or you will be run away. You don't even see the tiger. There will be running race between the tiger and you. Right? So, but Dhruva was very focused. He didn't want to get up from his place until he meets Vishnu and tells his problem. Can you be so focused in anything in life? So that until we reach the success, we don't move. Is it possible? Not possible. Why? Why not possible?
We should make it possible.
How to make it possible?
If an elephant comes, we should think it does not eat other animals.
He doesn't even see elephant. He is only seeing Vishnu. When he is focused completely on Vishnu, he doesn't even see elephant. Doesn't see tiger. Can we be so focused that once we are doing something, we should so focused, nothing bothers us? Is it possible?
If we make it possible, it becomes possible for us.
Ah, very good. So, did you understand my question, Ojal?
Yeah.
So, what did you learn? He is so focused that he doesn't even see elephant, doesn't see the tiger.
He is so focused on finding Vishnu and telling him the problem that... Yeah. He can't see anything at all. He can't see anything else.
Do we have so much focus in our life? When you are studying, you are so focused that nothing we see? Our mind keeps going here and there.
Sometimes.
Okay. What about Pratik? What about Vinay? Vinit?
Yeah, I can. I have it
when I draw.
Oh, when you draw. Very good. Very good. What about Pratik? Vinit?
But maybe not while we're studying, but while playing sports or something.
Oh, we're playing sports. Very good. But we should develop that.
I can do it in studies. I have done it sometimes.
Okay.
But it's easier. It just comes faster if you're playing sports.
Yeah. But we should learn the art of focusing so that we don't get bothered by anything. Is it okay?
Yeah.
What about Jairam? Did you hear? Jairam?
Hello.
Yes, Jairam.
I couldn't hear you. There was a network problem.
Okay. So, did you hear the story?
Yeah, it got disconnected.
Okay. I told how Dhruva prayed for Bhagavan Om Namah Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Can you do so much of focus on studies or any subject? Both of you.
I think so.
Okay. Very good. So, I'll go further, okay?
Yeah.
The elephants and tigers didn't do any harm to him. Right? That's what happens when your dogs and all, when they bark, if you don't get scared, they don't do anything to you. But the moment you get scared, they'll chase you. So, he prays like this. Suddenly, Vishnu is not able to sit in Vaikuntha. This boy's prayer is pulling him. Okay. He in front from his heart, suddenly he appears in front of him. Yeah. Stands in front of him. Can you see the picture? And
yeah.
The Prabhupada is worried.
Jairam, can you mute, please?
Because he is not able to see him in his heart. He has disappeared. Why he is standing in front now? Okay. Vishnu asked Dhruva, what do you want? Okay. Dhruva says, I want my father to love me. Vishnu says, yes, he will. Blessed. Then Vishnu gives him blessing of becoming a king of the forest, king, and ruling very well. Then after that, he says, Vishnu will say that after ruling for long, many years, very happily living life, you will become a star in the sky. It became Dhruva star or pole star. It's called Dhruva star, means that star doesn't move. It's a focus. It representation for focus in life. Nothing will, once I am focused in life, I'll not move at whatever cost. That's why it's called pole star. It's called Dhruva Nakshatra. You understand? So it motivates us. It inspires us. A small kid of 6 years can have so much of focus, so much of courage to achieve what he wants in life. That's why the pole star or Dhruva star is a motivator. Are you clear? We should become like Dhruva. Anything we take, focus. Not moving. Success. Possible?
Become
possible
means we should make it.
Ah, we should make it. Is everybody clear?
Yes.
Shall we go further?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, now I'll tell you about the mind. Are you able to see the picture in your mind? See, our mind, a small portion of the mind is what we see from outside, conscious mind. It's called conscious mind. 95% of our mind is deep inside. It's called subconscious mind.
Okay.
The subconscious mind is responsible for all our success in life and failure in life. It helps us, it guides us. Okay. So now I'll give you a small exercise. Please think, do the exercise, okay? Think over the exercise and do it, okay? Close your eyes and imagine there is a wooden piece, 1 foot wide and 10 feet length, okay? And start walking on the wooden piece. It's on the floor, start walking on the wooden piece and cross over and go to the other side. When you reach the other side, please open your eyes. Are you able to walk? Everybody?
Yeah.
Everybody did on the internet?
Yes.
Easy to walk?
Yeah.
Ojal?
Yeah.
Vineet?
Yes.
Yes.
Now, next exercise. So imagine 100 floor building, big 100 floor building, 200 floor building. And between 200 floor building, same wooden plank is kept from one floor, one building to other building. Okay? You understand the difference? So now you walk from this building to other building on that wooden floor. Imagine. Earlier you are able to walk now easily. Now imagine walking from this floor to other floor, other building. You're not scared.
My imagination.
Okay.
I'm a little scared.
Who? Ojal?
Yeah, I'm a little scared. I'm not that scared of heights usually.
Okay. So now reduce the width from 1 foot to half a foot. Now walk. It's easy.
How?
Okay, but are you able to walk? Look below. That's so. See, just walking. See this below. How deep it is. If you fall, no bone will be the left. Just imagine. Okay, slightly wider.
But in imagination, I can do, but not in physical.
Okay. Okay, slightly in case. No, 1 feet is this much. Okay. 1 feet. In case it's 1 feet. 1 feet.
1 feet.
Okay, 1 feet. Okay. 1 feet, 1feet, not increase it. 1 feet, maybe 1 feet. Okay. And just see how deep it is. What will happen if you fall?
Just
no. 100. Building is 100 feet. 100 floors. 100 floors above. If you fall like this, what will happen? Okay. So how did you? Now just see little bit this side and that side and then go. See how beautiful is the scenario? How beautiful is the scenario? Just this side and that side. And see how deep it is and walk. Ojal, did you see how deep it is?
It's, yeah.
How it is like
pretty deep. It's just like a road beneath me full of cars and all. Going on a very fast speed.
Okay. Are you able to complete the walk?
I'm halfway through.
Okay. What about Jairam? Hello? Vineet?
Yes.
Are you able to complete the walk?
Yes. Yeah, I somehow I did.
Somehow you did. Well, what happens? Why first time walking on the floor is easy compared to walking on the height?
The fear that if you fall down, there's nothing left. But if you're
they support the floor,
if you fall down, right? Nothing's gonna happen.
Okay, the fear is there, right? Second case. Yeah. But really, can you fall? Because of the which is what we're doing, you won't fall. But imagination of fear causes problem.
Yeah.
So which is the in our life? Our imagination creates problems. You understood? Mm-hmm. Logical issue of imagination creates a problem. Are you clear? There's no really problem. Do you understand, Ojal?
Yeah.
That's all. So, did you understand, Vineet?
Yes.
Our problems in life are caused by our imagination, poor imagination.
Yeah, we label it as a problem.
And then create fearings. So we should learn how to imagine positively. Are you clear?
Yes.
So
take it as a learning.
Okay. Our imagination becomes stronger. If you see the next picture, our brain has different waves. A faster wave called gamma, beta, alpha, theta, and delta. As the brain wave becomes slower, okay, our imagination becomes more clear. This beta is your normal thinking. Now what you are doing is beta, first thinking brain. So if you are able to reduce the speed of thinking, calm down, then the imagination becomes clear, and you can create a very positive imagination. Are you clear? Everybody understood that?
Yeah.
Ojal?
Yeah, understood.
Jairam?
Yeah.
Okay, and who else is there? Somebody disappeared. No, there was one more person, no?
Jairam.
Okay. Vineet disappeared. Vineet. Okay, let us do now. I'll teach you how to calm your mind so that your imagination becomes clear. Okay. So it is important that we learn how to calm our mind to make our imagination sharper and clear, focused. Okay. So just take your attention to this place where you put your kumkum and the tikka. Just don't have to move your eyes. Just gently become aware of that. Is everybody able to do that? Now, breathe stomach very slowly, not fast. 5 counts in, 5 counts out. So breathe in, breathe out. Mentally say, slowly open your eyes. Do you feel peaceful?
Yeah. Yes, yes.
So, with this method, we can make our mind peaceful. Okay?
Yeah.
So, your breathing speed reduces and breathe deep and focus here. So, your mind starts calming down. Okay? Now, how to apply it in our life, I'll tell you. This is called creating your own life, right? All of us want something in life, okay? So first down, write down clearly what you want to do in life, not after 10 years. Always focus on next 6 months exam, not after 10 years or something. What is it? Focus on what you have to do next 6 months, okay? Then that's called what I call goal. Then create a storyboard. Create a storyboard. You know what is a storyboard? Everybody knows what is a storyboard?
Yes. Storyboard.
Okay. I'll ask Peter. Ojal, do you know what is a storyboard?
No. I don't know what a storyboard is.
I know what's a vision board. I don't know what's a storyboard.
Yeah, vision board is storyboard. Okay.
Okay.
So, you have to write pictorically on a board what you want to vision.
That's the storyboard, yeah.
Right?
Okay. Yeah.
Can you see this? So, you have to create, imagine as if it is really happening.
This is how your house will be success in that we travel.
No, no, I'm. Yeah, are you able to understand? You may create a storyboard of what you want to achieve, right? So don't write as if, make a picture, make a drawing or picture to see as if it is happening. Not what will happen. For example, let us say, I'll ask Shiva, what do you want in the next 6 months? What is important thing in this 6 months? Next 6 months. Okay. So Shiva wants 95%. What about Atreya?
Study.
Means what?
To be able to complete all my study.
Okay, what about you?
Have a test next weekend. Someone heard it on me.
Make your friends. Okay. What do you want to achieve overall? What will happen to you if you do this?
Yeah, target for next
6 months. Next 6 months.
No.
You have to put it down. You have to say what you want to do. Yes.
Achieve in my exams.
What?
School exams.
Okay, so you have to make it into pictures. Okay, write whatever picture you want. Create a board as if it is happened. Right, for example, 95% marks, your marks card 95% should look there. Okay, then another picture should be there. Your mom and father are congratulating you. Right, the school teachers are. They don't do
school teacher. No, they just give merit card.
Okay. Mother. So visualize everything what happens to you if that goal is achieved. Correct? And visualize how will you study? Sit, study, focus like Dhruva, focus, study. How will you do? No, I'm saying no, don't do it right now. I'm saying what you have to do in home.
Home is draw?
Yeah. You have to make a board. No, unless you draw a vision board, it will not become. Test pass.
You will not be there.
Okay. Okay. Did you understand? Once you go home, you visualize what all will happen to you if you achieve that. Correct? You have to visualization has to become clear. That's the idea is that your imagination should become very clear. Right? Not just vague. The more clear your imagination, the more real it will happen. And imagine it's happening. You are preparing very well, you are becoming very successful, you are very happy, your parents are congratulating, everything you have to visualize fully. Did you understand, Ojal?
Yeah.
Did you understand, Jairam?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Then,
yes.
You have to create slogans for your life.
Create
a suggestion for your life. Slogan. A punchline. What is the punchline? You understand?
Yeah.
Get good marks in exams.
Huh?
Get good marks in exams.
Get good marks in exam is actually you say get good marks. You have to say, I am very successful. I am getting good marks. It's always
the present, and it should be short.
Present tense, not in the future. Right? You understand?
Mm.
Huh? It should be a colorful slogan. It should be very spicy. It should be in your head. I mean, it should be. It should really be imaginative. You understand what a slogan means?
Slogan
be tell me what is that? You will write.
Slogan is of the vision board.
No, for you in life. Next 6 months, I am becoming topper for the in the school or whatever is that, right? What is the best? I am the best. Understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay. What is going to be a slogan? Let's say quickly one round. Whatever. Atreya.
Some line.
That is line. It should be present tense, not the future.
You understood, right?
Yeah. Okay. Let us start Shiva. Mommy is happy. So what if you want to make a slogan, what will you do? Atreya, Aditya.
What?
Prabhuji. Prabhuji.
Yeah, yes. Vinit.
Can you just tell Kritik what is a slogan?
Slogan means what is important, no? What if you want to line, tell in one line.
His summary.
What do you want to achieve? What will you do?
One line, what will you do? All those ideas, one line.
One line.
Thank you.
All my.
What is that?
I said thank you.
Huh?
Thank you. Thank you for telling him.
Oh, thank you for telling. Okay. So Vinit, if you're telling one line, what do you do?
I am rich, I am clear, I am peaceful.
Okay. Okay, you have covered everything. Okay. So actually you should make it present continuous tense. Okay.
That's why I said I am.
Day by day, I am becoming richer, richer, richer. I am becoming more and more peaceful. Day by day, I am becoming more and more happy. You have to make it continuous. tense, not
okay.
Because you keep on improving. Are you clear? Jairam? Yeah. What about you? Mummy is becoming happier day by day. Okay. What about Naveen?
In next 6 months, I want to, in all my exams, I should get all correct.
Okay. Day by day, I am becoming more and more and more perfect.
Yeah.
Okay. It should be continuous tense. Day by day, I am becoming more and more good, perfect. Right? Okay, what about you?
I'm becoming more and more helpful.
To whom?
Everyone.
Okay. So, what has that to do with this goal? If you become more and more helpful, you'll become get good marks in exam. So okay, please understand why it is important. Okay, one is our left brain requires a slogan, right brain requires imagination. Okay, imagination is done on the board, slogan is given to the right brain, the left brain. So together they act like very powerfully. Okay. And you should use this slogan and imagination to just before going to sleep. Okay. So then what will happen? It will go deep inside the mind. I showed you 95% mind is deep. So when it goes deep inside the mind, 100% it will become successful.
Anything that goes in subconscious, 100%. Yeah.
So, just before going to sleep, every day you have to repeat this slogan and imagine what is going to be, how you are successful you are going to be. Understood, everybody? So, this is called, yeah. You understood?
Yeah.
So, just before going to sleep, then what will happen? It will go deep inside your mind. Got it? So, every day you should do it, then you will guarantee that 100% it will happen. Are you clear?
Yeah.
So this is this procedure is clear. It's called creative visualization. Okay. So now do this. Go back home and experiment it So it requires one is picture creation, which is called vision board or story board. Then writing a slogan and imagining every day, night when you are going to the sleep, imagine what's happening, what will happen, and use the slogan. And I guarantee you 100% will happen. So will you experiment? All of you?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So you'll experiment?
Yes.
What
yes.
Else?
Yes.
Okay. We need?
Yes.
Okay. So Jairam is not visible. Jairam, are you there?
Even I'll do it.
Okay. Nothing. Okay. Okay, so today we'll close the class. Okay, next class will be taken by either Venkatji or Vasu. Okay, so let us close. Asatoma.
Asatoma.
Sadgamaya.
Sadgamaya.
Tamasoma.
Tamasoma.
Tamasoma. Sadgamaya.
Sadgamaya.
Mrityorma.
Mrityorma.
Amritam Gamaya.
Amritam Gamaya.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Lokah Samastah.
Lokah Samastah.
Sukhino Bhavantu.
Sukhino Bhavantu.
Lokah samastah.
Lokah samastah.
Bhavantu.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Lokah samastah.
Loka samasaha.
Bhavantu.
Namantu.
Hari
Om.
Hari Om.
Namaha.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
So I have given you how to become successful. I have given. Try to do that. Apply it in your life and become like Dhruva. Very focused. Very successful. Okay. Bye. Okay. Good night.
Thank you, Prabhuji.